Welcome back, and let's continue our talk on the Abus Titalium padlock, which I have disassembled, as you can see. Just by the way, sorry that I haven't done the video on the Tokots Pro disc set. I'm still researching there, it's taking more time than expected, and I will do this video as soon as possible. But let's get to the Titalium, especially the 90-50 series, which, as you can see, you can fully disassemble. We already talked about the core, and that I got this information from lockpicking101.com that this number here is for the keyway restriction. And yeah, I've taken a look here at the core and wanted to know if there is any drill protection, but as you can see, there is not, and I doubt that this is hardened material. But on the other hand, we got an aluminium padlock here, so I'd say that drill protection is not that important. We all know that aluminium is very, very easy to drill or to cut. So let's take a look at the other part of the core here, which I've also shown you this little drilling here, which I do not know what it's for. And this pin here, which will prevent us from overturning the core and then all the pins from falling out. Then we got this little part here at the back, which is there to lock the ball bearing mechanism when you turn the key. Yeah, we got this little ring here. Someone told me what the name of this ring is, but I forgot it again. Sorry about that. We have the ball bearings, of course, nothing special here. We got our stainless steel shackle. Everything very good in quality, very good in tolerances. And another part of the ball bearing locking mechanism. Come on, camera, please focus. The larger drill hole on the opening side of the shackle and the smaller drill hole on the part where the shackle is not supposed to come out. Okay, let's take a look at the pins. Let's try to zoom in a little bit here. But there is nothing really special. We got a lot of spools here, as you can see. A lot of normal pins here on the upside. These are all non-serrated. Or let's take a look. Does this one have a... No, this one doesn't have a serration. Oh, but this here, this pin, at first sight, it looked like a normal pin to me. Let's get back to our normal focus. Let's get a closer look at this. I would say this is a pin with a serration. If there is a book online that I could buy where all the names for all the different pins are listed, and I would be happy if you told me about that book, because I do not have that lot of information on pins yet. I do know most of the German names for the pins, but not the names, the English translations for all the pin names. Okay, let's take a look at the body of the Titalium padlock again. I'm going to tell you why I really, really like this padlock. First of all, the tolerances here on the Titalium padlock are very good, I'd say. Then, second of all, we got two drainage holes. We got one down here, and we got another drainage hole on the side here. And this drainage hole on the side, if you can hopefully see it down here, really has a little cut. Here's a little cut here in the body of the padlock. So the water will really be forced to get out of that hole, and it cannot stay down there because there's a screw. Maybe the screw will rust, but that is the only thing that can that I can imagine can happen. Also, as you hopefully will see here, they machine some material off here in the middle, and if you put the balls in here, they will actually mostly stay in the middle. And this is really a cool feature, which no one has done so far, or I have never seen it on a padlock yet. And I really have to say, I love this Titalium padlock. It's one of my favorites at the moment. It costs €30 here in Germany. I don't know about America, but you may check that out. I hope you enjoyed this video, and feel free to subscribe. Have a nice day and take care. Bye bye.